Hey, welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Dr. Bob Lee. Our next guest is a pastor, mentor, and entrepreneur, and motivational speaker, and he joins us today to share about his father's story and the work he is doing to seek justice. Welcome Pastor Lamar M. Whitehead. He was on the show before, the founder of Leaders of Tomorrow in Brooklyn. Brooklyn's in the house, in the boogie down, BX. Yes. All right, so how you doing?
I'm doing good, man. And yourself?
Good. With all this, all the things that are happening in our community, a lot of violence all over the place, black-on-black crime, violence around the world, really. But you want to shed some light on something that happened about 35, 36 years ago, something like that. Share a little bit about Arthur Miller. That's your dad, right?
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Well, my father, Arthur Miller, was killed by the chokehold. The officers used a baton to crush his windpipe. So he was the first man to be choked to death in New York City. And of course, you know, because of the color of his skin, the officers wasn't indicted and it was swept under the rug. And with this, you know, young man, Eric Gardner, you know, that seeing him being choked to death gave me a visual that I never knew how my father died. So it really took an impact on me. And, you know, being a young man growing up without a father, you run into a lot of different walls just to become a man. And, you know, just seeing that young man die like that brought a lot of emotions out of me. Things and questions that I had about the murder of my father. So, you know, the community, the black, Hispanic community, the less fortunate communities that have a lot of fatherless homes gives avenue and application for error within the house.
Because it affected your childhood somehow, right? Tell us about that.
Yeah, it affected my childhood a lot. You know, growing up, just not understanding how to be a man, and younger, being led in different directions. And then at 27 years old, I was illegally convicted. But, you know, scripture says clearly that the enemy takes away the strong man to attack the house. So I feel that if my father was around, that would have never happened, but it did happen. And that's why I am a pastor and an activist to teach and tell young men about their rights and how they are strong men and how they have value. Because, you know, yes, I was convicted. And
what did they try to convict you of?
Grand larceny, scheme to defraud. And what happened was I was convicted when I was 27 years old for something that they claim happened 5 years prior when I was 22 years old. Just because I was a successful businessman. And now...
And you feel that all this was kicked up because of a fatherless household?
Yeah, I think my father could have protected me more, to be more wise and understand, because there were lawyers that duped me for a lot of money, you know, and I thought that they were doing the proper things within my case, but they weren't. And now we're finding out how the district attorney hid evidence from my attorney. I have affidavits from my attorney stating to the judges, like, listen, these district attorney hid information so that they can convict this man. But this goes on and on in the community, man. They use us as stepping stones.
And you mentioned something off camera about the movie Do the Right Thing. And I told you I was in that movie. I was a riot cop, you know, trying to hold back the people who were rioting, trying to push the fire people over to keep them from dying out the fire of the burning pizza shop. So how does that fit into this?
Well, Spike Lee dedicated that movie to my father. And if you look at the scene where Radio Raheem died and got choked by the baton, that was how my father died. So that's where they got that scene from. You know, I just, like I said, man, growing up, I'm a 36-year-old pastor, young pastor. I don't have the same ideology as the traditional
pastors. You didn't say that when you were on the set before. Were you just ordained?
Yes, I was installed as pastor about 2 months ago.
Okay.
I was minister for almost 10 years, and now I'm installed as pastor.
So,
So, you know, there's a lot of traditional thinking with other pastors where that they only think inside the four walls of the church. But I truly believe that a lot of people that's going to go to heaven and be saved with salvation are the people outside of the four walls of the church, you know, and that's not stuck on tradition, not stuck on religion, but a relationship with God.
That's wonderful. Beautiful. Do you think it is possible for the community and NYPD to have a good relationship?
Yes.
They have some things in the community that bring people together, to have Harmony Day and those community affairs officers, they're right there in the community all the time. Like, they know how to act.
Right. Well, I've met with a lot. I've met with the District Attorney of Brooklyn. I've met with a few commanding officers of different precincts. And that's what we want to do. But the thing about it, the key is the young people don't trust us. So therefore, we have to regain the trust back. Mm-hmm. So what I've created with Leaders of Tomorrow Brooklyn, I have different initiatives mm-hmm. where we have initiative with BET. So we bring 400 or 500 kids to 106 in Park. We have a hospital initiative where we expose kids if you want to be an ophthalmologist or a radiologist or a gynecologist yeah. so that they can shadow doctors. We're also going to start planning softball, basketball games against the yeah. police stations and the basketball games so that they can commune. And it's not only kids getting arrested or if 911 is called that they see the police presence. Yeah. So I think if the community come together like that, I think we'll be all right.
Wonderful. And the last time you were here, Uncle Ralph was with you. He's yes. a part of your program, right?
Yeah, he's the vice president of yeah. my company, yes. And yeah. me and Ralph McDaniels, we are really combating this youth initiative to the fullest. Mm-hmm. We're also working with the borough president of Brooklyn, Eric Adams, and he's just been phenomenal. The last time we was up here, we had...
You had a function coming
right,
up, right?
The Brooklyn Team that? Summit. It was awesome. It was about 500 youth. Ralph McDaniel's been playing it on Video Music Box. We have a lot of feedback. All I asked Dr. Bob, man, is if our community really come together. You don't see this disconnect yeah. or discord in any other community. You know, we talk about one another in our community. Mm-hmm. We, as pastors, a lot of pastors are in competition. Who's has the biggest congregation? Who wow. raised the most money? Stupidity. You know, and our young people are out there killing each other. There's no sense of direction. And now God is shifting the atmosphere.
What about outreach?
Outreach for the church?
Yeah, to get out there to right. deal with the people who are acting up in our communities.
Right. When you're so caught up with your own selfish ideologies and intentions, you forget about the outreach. You know, and our young kids are, I'm tired of the young people being a stepping stone to somebody else's career mm-hmm. because I was a stepping stone for somebody else's career. With my father's death, there were so many different elected yeah. officials, mm-hmm. politicians, media that used that as a stepping stone for their career. You know?
So, but the police department is going for training now. You think things like this will help?
I think they need to train the attitude first. And, you know, like I said, if they have more open arms, because granted, this is a mean streets out here. Mm-hmm. Okay, but if they come together and understand the community mm-hmm. and not come from out of their community into our community and not understanding, then it'll be a better place. And with this training, you have to understand, Bob, this chokehold was outlawed 36 years ago. 36 years ago. And my father wasn't the first, but he wasn't the last person to be choked to death. Mm-hmm. And to see that man die on tape was incredible. And when I went to his funeral, I was in my own world. You know, yeah, I'm a pastor.
You're thinking about
I was father. Reliving because I was only 6 weeks old. So I was actually reliving mm-hmm. what my father went through, seeing all of the people angry, the elected officials speech, they having speeches, singers, and I'm just sitting there saying, wow, this is how it looked when my father died. Yeah. All the news media. You know, so I was just in a different place, yeah. man, because I'm a very real person. I was just in a different place, a different yeah. season within that funeral, man. Mm-hmm. I just trying to understand, you know.
Where can we get more information on what you're doing and, you know, the things that you're doing in the community with your organization?
Well, if you go on leadersoftomorrowbrooklyn.org, mm-hmm. That's my website. It's all spelled out, Leaders of Tomorrow Brooklyn.
There you go.
And you can go, you can see the different events that's coming up because we have a plethora of events that's coming up. We're about to update the site.
You're going to post up some of the things yeah. that we spoke about.
Yes, we're going to post all of all right. that. And we're planning a big, big fundraiser. I'll be back on your shoulder to reveal it. But it's going to be a very, very big fundraiser in Brooklyn that we want everybody to come out with to support our youth.
There you go. Lamar Whitehead, founder, Leaders of Tomorrow. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks
for stopping by.
I appreciate you,
all
man.
All right, you got it, man.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to take a short break. But up next, we'll take a good look at an exciting event for good cause. Stay tuned.